Howdy folks, Mr. Ramsey B here, and this is going to end up being another cooking tutorial, but first we have to go to the store and get a couple things. So we are here at the Meijer, here in our town, here in Jackson. They've already got their fall stuff out. Let's take a look, got some birds. My mother loves little scarecrows like these. Landa's mom does too. My wife's mom. Got some pumpkins. Some pumpkins. Need to find some snow peas to put inside those pumpkins. Yeah, I've been playing Plants vs. Zombies quite a bit. Low clearance. Alright, but we just gotta go inside now. You guys are about to see how dorky I am. Yes, so there's a couple things that we have to pick up. Oh, they've already got their pumpkin carving stuff out. All right. Glug, 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 glug. No. I don't drink at all, in any way, shape, or form. I'm going to apologize ahead of time if the audio, if my commentary here, my audio is horrible, if it's like really quiet. But I don't want people, other people in the store, to think I'm an absolute loon, so, yes. Soda! Lots and lots of soda. The fish. I like fish. I kinda like these guys. Look at this guy. Alrighty. Here we go. This is what we're looking for here today. Three for six. That's not a bad price. Got a coupon. All right, so. Grab a big old thing of mozzarella. Ooh, it's mozzarella and provolone. Mozzarella and provolone. That's nice. Alright. So. Oh, I still feel kind of like crap. Yes, but we went to the baby doctor this morning, and everything is going fine. Our due date is still January 11th. Rice cakes! Yes. So January 11th, she hasn't decided yet whether or not we want to find out if it's a boy or a girl, which is frustrating for me. The other thing that we're going to get today, 2 bottles of Coke Zero. Oh boy, these things are a little heavy. I now realize why a lot of people that do video blogs like this point the camera at the ground when they're walking through a store or so whatnot. Because a lot of people don't like being randomly recorded. In fact, I've been in here about 10 minutes and I've already been yelled at by 2 of the other customers. But I should not be recording them. The way I look at it is, if you're not doing anything wrong, what's the problem? Alright. So, we're going to do the self-checkout because most of the cashiers at the store are idiots. Alright. Put my sodas down.
Welcome. Please scan your first item. If you have check refunds, coin star, coupons, or bottle slips, please scan them at the end of your order. Please place item in the bagging area.
These were marked 3 for $6. So believe you me, I'm getting this for $2. These are marked back there 3 for $6.
The 8 ounce, are not the 12. It's 8 ounce.
8 ounce. The sign was pointing at these.
The sign is right here. A 12-ounce are up here, 8-ounce are
right under. There's a tag with an arrow pointing right at these.
Pointing down?
Yep.
Because the 12-ounce are clear on the top. So the 12-ounce are the very top shelf.
That was not on the...
It's not the 8-ounce ones that are...
Gotta love Meijer not giving a crap about their customers. Yeah, yeah, the... We have to call and have the sign fixed because the bag of cheese is in the wrong spot and the sign is incorrect, but yet they're not going to give it to me for the price that it's listed for. So, we'll see about this. Let's see what the lady does. Actually, we'll be right back. So, once again, Meijer screws over their customer and, you know, pretty much shows how little they actually give a crap about business. Because he went and printed a new sign, brought it up to me, and said pretty much, screw you, you're not getting it for the advertised price. So, you know what? Screw him. I don't even care. There are other options. We can go over to Kroger, which is just less than a block up the road. And that's what we're going to do, so I'll meet you there. Alright, so here we are at Kroger, and we're gonna, I mean, this company ain't much better than Meijer, but at least the people here don't have, at least the managers here aren't smart asses and are actually willing to help the customer if they've been legitimately wronged, which at Meijer we definitely were. Cho is a thing, though. I don't know where anything is in this store. Excuse me. Where do I find shredded cheese?
Bad flowers and dairy.
Thank you. Oh, excuse me. Aisle 14, cheese. Okay, so man, 2 for $4. Okay. 8 ounce. Yeah, that'll work. Get off there. Okay, so Kroger brand mozzarella cheese, 8 ounce package. Now, for what we're going to be making, you can actually use any cheese or any mozzarella cheese, but it's got to be mozzarella. I know we're not making a pizza. Okay. 3 for $10. The 1 liter bottles here, do they? No, figures they wouldn't. Oh boy, she'll probably yell at me if I get that. Yeah, I'll just get a 2 liter and call it a day. They do. But, yeah, they do have the 1 1/4 liters, but it doesn't look like they have it in Coke Zero. And considering I don't want diabetes again, we're gonna have to stick with this one. All right, cola. Oh, 88 cents. Yeah, I don't know about that. All right. Alright. Alrighty, so let's give self-checkout another try. Alright. Oh, excuse me. Wow.
Scan your shopper's card for 1-2-3 reward paper. or enter your restaurant ID. Otherwise, scan your next order.
And that's not even in a bag. What? Oh, yeah, I guess. That'll work.
If you have cooking, press the cooking button. Otherwise, slide your card and follow the instructions on the pin pad.
I hate these things.
Amy, 2104, please.
Because you never put in your pin pad or your pin number at a pin pad.
Thank you for shopping with us.
It's my wallet. See, there's my driver's license and all my stuff. Alrighty. Oof. See, a lot less eventful than the screw-up over at Meijer. So, yeah. Cigarettes, smoke, cigars, ATM, Lotto, claw game. Yeah. Yep. Alright, so, we are leaving the store. And I'll meet you guys back at the house. In the kitchen. So we'll see you there. Alright, bye-bye. Alrighty, so we're back here at the house, and we have some feta cheese in a bowl, looking very nice. There's two things I'm going to show you how to make today. Number one is crock pot lasagna. Very easy to make, very, very delicious, very yummy. Okay, so I took the liberty of putting the ragout into the bowl already. The next thing that you want to add is our cheese. We do have a brick of mozzarella in the fridge, but I didn't want to spend an hour grinding on a block of cheese to get a cup and a half, which is what's needed. So, yeah. Let's open up the cheese here. Yes, I am using my cell phone to record this. It is a better camera than my actual phone. So, sorry if there's some weird camera angles, but pretty much, that looks about good. And we're just going to go ahead and mix that up. Toss it around a little bit. It doesn't have to be perfect. You want to make sure you're using low moisture on both the ragatta and the mozzarella. Have it all mixed up there. I'm going to take this time to remind everybody that Mr. Ramsey B, that's me, has a Facebook page now, which is very nice. Okay, so we're going to need the spaghetti sauce. We're going to need some Italian seasonings for the meat. Chili powder, not so much. Garlic, definitely. Excuse me. Salt and pepper. going to use the actual good stuff. Normal salt. And not the powdered, but the grinder. And... where is it? Parsley. That's what I'm looking for. So... right there, that's a good amount. Nice little couple taps. Couple little taps. Now I gotta go over here to the fridge. And I should put some grape juice in here. Leftover grape juice. I'm gonna put that down here next to the eggs. Grab out the Parmigiana. Put the grape juice back up here. And grab out our eggs. We're going to need those too. Alright. So the Parmesan, you just open up the big mouth side and... that's good. I like Parmesan cheese, so I use a little bit more than what most people do. I'm going to mix this up and we'll be right back. And we're back, and one thing you may notice is that the cheese does look a little bit yellower, if that's even a word, than it did a minute ago. And the reason for that is because, I'm going to put the phone down, I'll put it right here for a sec. No, because it'll come off. We don't want that, so let's put it right here on the knife. Now, the reason for that is because... you need to crack an egg into it and mix it up nice and good. You definitely want to make sure it's mixed up nice and good, because otherwise you'll have cheese with a hair bit of egg in there, and that's just not yummy. That's a weird texture and a weird flavor. So we're going to grind in a little bit of pepper, which you just heard me doing, and you just mix it up a little bit more. And pretty much, that's your mix for your lasagna cheese. You can do that. I'm going to put a little bit more parsley in here because it's not quite green enough for my taste. I like it to be a little bit greener. So we put in a little bit more parsley. I'm going to throw in a little bit of sage, because I like sage. Sage is nice. Adds a nice little hint of flavor when you put in just a little bit. You just got to make sure you fold it around nice and good. Forgive me if all you can see is my elbow. I do apologize. I know it makes for great video. Hey, look, it's Mr. Ramsey B's elbow. All right. Yes. Okay, so we've got our cheese done up. The next step is to take our meat, which we have defrosted using water. And we have to cook it in a pan. Cook it up, brown it up nice and good. And then we're going to add the spaghetti sauce into it so we make a meat sauce. And I will come. We'll come back after that's all been done. Alrighty, and we're back. And as you can see, we have our meat sauce made and steaming. We've got our cheese done up. We have our noodles. That's 6 lasagna noodles broken in half. I did 6. I'm thinking all you really need is 4 or 5 for an average size crock pot, but I'm doing 6 just in case. Very important step is you want to put some sauce, just plain old sauce, in the bottom of the pan first. And very simply, you just put in your noodles. And then you take, I'm gonna grab a spoon. Take a spoon of cheese. Doesn't have to be a huge spoon of cheese, just a little bit. On each noodle. And then some meat sauce. A little more over here. Sorry, I just realized I'm not even aiming the camera at what I'm doing. And then you want to grab your mozzarella cheese, put it over here, grab some, and put it over the top. And you just stack it up like that. So I'm going to stack it up, and we'll be back in a minute. Alrighty, so now that we're all stacked up, I do need to let you know that it did take 10 lasagna noodles to stack up this crock pot lasagna here. So, pretty much, let's see if I can do it one-handed. Hopefully I can. Oh, jeez. Okay, maybe not. It's a little heavy. So we put this on top of the crock pot, and we set it to low. And where's the lid? Here's the lid. We put the lid on. And we just let it be. Let it be. In about 6 hours, you will have primo nom nom lasagna come up. Okay, but now, the next thing that I want to teach you how to make here, that's dinner. So right now, we're working with, sorry for all the dishes, it's normally not like that. We are going to send McDonald's for a loop, and I'm going to let the secret out. Alright, so what we're going to need for this is mayonnaise. We're going to need some yellow mustard, and we are going to need some dill weed. Ground up if you can. Ground up is always going to be better. So we have some, we've got it ground up a little somewhat here, so that's good enough. So forgive me, don't have a tripod for my phone. So we're going to take a spoon. We're going to take one block. And we're going to take two heaping blops. Yes. It's already looking good. Holy cow. Not really. But we're going to take mustard. Squirt that in there. We're going to take the dill weed. It doesn't take a lot of dill to do this. Maybe about that much. And we're gonna mix it up. And I'll be right back. Alrighty, and we're back. And if that looks familiar to anybody, it's because when you go to McDonald's and you order yourself a bagel, that's the sauce they put on it. That is the McDonald's bagel sauce right there. I put in just a hair too much mustard, which might be why it's a little bit yellower than it really should be. But that's okay because I kind of like it that way. So pretty much, mayonnaise, Hellmann's, actually Miracle Whip type stuff is the best stuff because it gives you a little bit of tanginess. So Miracle Whip, yellow mayonnaise, and dillweed. That's about all she wrote. So, thank you very much for watching. I'm going to do my best to get a Final Fantasy video up today, but if I can't, then, well, you know I can't. Enjoy. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of my video blog. Yeah. So, pretty much, I guess that's it. I didn't really think up a closing, but we'll talk to you later. Have a good afternoon, and be safe.